troubled by moral injury because they feel that they've lost their moral compass. They feel that their colleagues in particular might not have behaved properly in a moral way. They have some concerns about their news organization behaving in a moral way. Some of the guilt that comes with moral injury was self-directed as well. Some of the journalists felt that they themselves had let themselves down in terms of their behavior. Post-traumatic stress disorder is not an issue in this group. We didn't find high rates of depression in journalists. We didn't see significant substance abuse. Individuals who were covering the story in their own country were more vulnerable. We found that journalists who have children were more susceptible to moral injury. Interestingly enough, we did not see a gender or sex difference, which sets it apart from post-traumatic stress disorder, where you tend to see higher rates in women. Depression as well, you see higher rates in women, but in moral injury, we didn't see that. Journalists need to understand what they can do and what they can't do in the field. They need to understand what their role is. These things still need to be defined, because in the migrant crisis, what we saw is at times journalists were pushed into working as first responders. You know, how involved do you get in the story? You know, what's the dividing line between working as a journalist and working as a first responder? You know, how emotionally close do you get to the people you're covering? Journalists are subject to all sorts of new stresses. For example, in the United States, I've come across journalists who have been covering the hurricanes, the natural disasters. This is interspersed with mass shootings. It's also mixed up with the journalists being threatened as part of the media in the United States by the right wing. It's in the context of social media, so they're constantly in the public eye. There's a 24-hour news cycle, there's no downtime. So when you take all these factors and wrap them up together, you have a very difficult situation for journalists to confront. They're not too sure at times what to do, how to behave under those circumstances. They start second-guessing themselves. They start doubting whether they've made the right call. And that is a conduit, in some ways, to moral injury. Ultimately, it's up to journalists to find the answers. I don't think you can get outsiders to come in and tell you what to do. I think there are going to be unique aspects to moral injury, things that are unique to journalists. And how are you going to navigate your way through them? Obviously, having a discussion with people like myself, but ultimately, there needs to be a journalistic solution to a journalist's problem.